Let's look at other examples to clarify why new features in living things, when carefully examined, turn out to be evidence against evolution. Living things are actually devolving, not evolving.
Okay, so here's an example of genetic change that was again cited as evidence for evolution. This is an example from long ago. Darwin called attention to wingless beetles on the island of Madeira. It's often windy on Madeira, and many of the normal winged beetles get blown off the island into the sea and or the ocean, and they die.
Ooh.
Yeah.
There was a mutation that caused some of the beetles to lose the ability to produce wings. The wingless mutant beetles then became the dominant population on the island, and that's still the situation today.
So, a genetic mutation causing a loss of wings caused population change over time. So, just like in the example of antibiotics, the beetles have become adapted to their environment, in this case as a result of a mutation. These wingless beetles are now better adapted to the windy environment than the non-mutant winged beetles. That's a great example of natural selection and adaptation, but it's not evolution.
Are you still confused? It's about the kind of change that took place. The beetles used to have wings, now they don't. That's actually the opposite of what evolution needs. They've lost the ability to fly. If they keep losing abilities, eventually they're going to lose the ability to live.
Yikes. That sounds more like extinction, not evolution. By the way, creationists wrote on natural selection and adaptation long before Darwin. Those are scientific facts supported by a lot of good examples. God created living things with the amazing ability to adapt to changing environments without going extinct at the slightest climate change, for example. It's good engineering. It's exactly what we'd expect if God created.
Exactly. That's right. Think of the term beneficial mutation. Evolutionists use that term quite a bit. But is there such a thing as a beneficial mutation? Yes, there is. A beneficial mutation is simply one that makes it possible for its possessors to contribute more offspring to future generations than the creatures that lack the mutation. The mutation in these beetles can be called a beneficial mutation.
I guess, from a certain point of view, but it's not beneficial for evolution. The mutation puts the beetle on the path to extinction. It's becoming genetically worse.
And that's the point. At a genetic level, it's going downhill, not uphill. The exact opposite of evolution.